In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. As Jesus walked in the community, he saw a blind man. And this man, the story says, had been blind since birth. The disciples asked Jesus, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, "Neither this man nor his parents sinned. He was born blind so that God's work might be revealed in him." Jesus answered, might sound a bit strange for us, but if we look at the belief system of that time, we will find that for ancient Israelites, healing was in the hands of God. That is the reason why Jesus answered in such a way. Jesus was expecting to see the glory of God as healing came to this blind man. Jesus continued to speak to the disciples, telling them that we must work the works of him who sent him while it's still day. Night is coming when no one can work. With these words, Jesus was telling his disciples that they were to do good in their communities. Likewise, we as individuals and as Holy Trinity as a whole have to seek for opportunities to help those in need. This loving action is in line with the teachings of Jesus. We are to emulate Jesus when he says, "As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world." For some of us, it takes time to realize that life is short. The clock is ticking. And that as long as we are alive, listen to this, as long as we are alive, we are the light to those around us. When the night of our lives comes, then there is darkness. That means that we're gone. We're dead. In other words, in that case, our opportunity to directly help others is gone. We are called to engage in the life of others. Sometimes we don't like it. Sometimes it's, you know, it gets difficult. But we are called to do so. Following the gospel reading, we heard that Jesus spat on the ground and made mud with saliva and spread the mud on the man's eyes, saying to him, "Go wash in the pool of Siloam." Then he went and washed and was able to see. Here we see Jesus as the physician taking care of a patient and prescribing to the man what to do to be healed. For the ancient Israelites, water was important for healing, for washing, for purification, and for sustaining life. We have to remember that water is life. Can you imagine a world without water? A world without clean water to drink? That is the reality of millions of people around the world. During my attendance at the Water Justice Conference at Trinity Institute in New York City this past week, I learned that according to the UNICEF, on average, women and children spend 200 million hours every day to collect water for their families. Just imagine that. 200 million hours every day. Let's care about the water quality in our town here in West Orange, New Jersey. And as Jesus teaches us, we are to take care of the needs of others. Thus, let us be concerned about the water issue around the world as well. Water is necessary for all living creatures, not just human beings. Perhaps this is why from the book of Genesis all the way to the book of Revelation, water is a common thread. We always talk about water in the Bible because water and life, they go together. As Jesus has healed the blind man, there were some people who complained. The Pharisees, they were concerned and upset because Jesus had healed this man on the Sabbath day. And the Sabbath day is supposed to be a holy day when you don't do anything but just be in the presence of God. When the man was confronted as to who the healer was, he told them, Jesus. And he called him a prophet, a man of God, a man who is worshiping God. Prophets are recognized by the people because of the work that they do in their communities, for the voices that they raise. And speaking of prophets, this past March 24th, we remember and honor the life of Oscar Romero, the Latin American saint, soon to become canonized in the Catholic Church. But our church, the Episcopal Church, already commemorates the life of Oscar Romero as a saint on March 24th, as it is recorded in the book Holy Women, Holy Men. Jesus is calling us to be active in the life of those around us. That's our calling. When we become a Christian, it's not just to come to church on Sundays, but here we come to fill our spirits with the energy of the living God so that we can go up there to become healers, prophets, and most of all, to be followers of Jesus. So that we can go around shining our light as we move around, wherever we go, in the communities where we work, we are to shine and do God's will. Amen. Amen.